Just started.
All right. Just like we
okay, all right then. Mist, it is your turn. So who's going to play Oraba and who's going to play Miro?
I will continue to play Oraba. I'll have his low life on my cap.
Hey, Miss, wanna do a rollsies for who to play Miru? Who loses has to play?
No, you go ahead.
Oh no! I don't want. I don't want to be responsible for Miru's death.
Well, either way, I'm responsible for her death, not you. Because I'm the healer.
You're only responsible for her damage, not her life.
Yeah, now the hat I put on seems very small. You're right, if you die, it's your fault. If anyone dies, it's your fault.
It's always the healer's fault. We'll just agree on that.
Then I will try to make Miru great again.
Okay, alright then. So, Mist, your turn.
See, who all needs to be healed? Is it just me?
Oh, I guess Miro also, right? I don't need.
Oraba is at 15 health.
Oh.
Yeah,
I can't see Miro.
Oraba is pretty hurt, and Miro is about half health.
Okay, so. Well, everyone, if you need it, gains 23 health.
Wow.
That's good for Oraba. Puts him up to 23 plus 15,
38. Who is tracking Miro's life right now?
You should.
But I don't have a right now.
Ah, you need control.
Do you have access to her?
No. I don't see anything.
Give you control.
Oh wait, Miru stuff. Okay, let's see. No, that's Chorios. The head. Who the fuck is Chorios? Ah, yeah.
Yeah, you remember, right?
I remember.
Plato, okay. Alright, you should be able to see Plato, Miru stuff and health and etc.
Okay, so let's see. So, 23, you said?
Yeah.
So,
okay, does that include also his mushrooms?
Like,
what?
You don't need to select Klaatu or Jastin.
Okay, well
what
then.
Is the question?
Let's see, it's just a. It works on up to 6. I needed healing. Mira needed healing, and Oraba needed healing, so I guess 3 others. Could be healed if needed.
Don't heal the vampires, it hurts them, so the mushrooms are left.
Yes, and there's one down, you could heal him. Who is it? You could heal
all Robin. 3 of them. There's three slots left afterwards. You can select 6.
I guess just Robin is down, the other aren't hurt.
And any of these things around me, these enemies around me, are they do they look damaged or close to dead?
The ones around you, okay, this one is very wounded. This one is injured.
And I'll pack that one south of me.
Do you not still have your spiritual weapon that can make an attack as well? Ah, no.
Bonus action. Just use my bonus action to heal.
Yeah. I don't think we're still blessed, right? But you should hit either way.
I don't think so, because Araba was the one blessing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
okay, drops so, concentration.
26 and... yes, that both hit.
I stand
up. Both of those hit, miss.
I stand up before using this... before attacking.
Okay.
Let's see.
Okay, all right, so that is a total of Divine Strike is on, right?
34.
That only gets used on one attack, sorry. Divine Strike.
Okay, all right, the first one or the second? Do you choose?
I would rather it be the second one, but I would that's your call, I guess. I would assume that.
Okay, we'll go with the first one. Okay, so that's a total of 8 damage and then 9 damage because it doesn't have D versus undead. Okay, the creature is still alive. Pretty heavily burnt with the radiant damage, but still alive.
Okay, well, that's all I can do at the moment.
Hey. Yes.
Don't forget, Mira does have a +2. Wait. Never mind, I used that on myself, not on her. Ignore that.
Alright.
Okay.
So, one of the turn Mushroom Mancer.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, so this one, okay. This one is stunned by Miru's thing. Yeah, by Miru's shield. So this golem, he is going to try to hit twice this one over here with a wrecking punch and a... Alright, so that is a natural one. So it is also prone, and it will try to do the other punch at disadvantage. So that is a 20 to hit.
Mm-hmm. One of the mushroom, this one or this one?
Yeah, this one. Okay, yeah. So that is 37 points of damage against this mushroom.
Oh, he's down. Beep.
Do they regenerate when they're unconscious as well?
I don't know.
No, when they die, they just come back at the end of the day. Okay. So they don't have death saving throws, they are just dead. Okay, this one is stunned as well, this one is stunned. And this one is the one that's in the duel with Justin. He is going to try to do the punch with a 25.
Wasn't he prone as well?
This one, no.
All right.
I don't have any indication of that.
Then he hits.
Okay, he is going to hit with a 28. Make a strength saving throw.
So that's a 13. Which I could beat with a Pact Boon Watch. Wait, I'm going to add a d6.
Come on. Okay.
And the watch starts to glow up. Nope, I don't make it.
Okay, so you are
pushed. Tad too late. And I take 14 bludgeoning, right?
Yes.
Ticket
he
halved.
Is then going to walk over here, charge at you, and will stomp you. So that is 25 to hit because you are prone.
That hits.
Okay, alright. That is total 22 points of bludgeoning damage. You must make a strength saving throw or take the 54 points of force damage.
Oh my god.
So I take 11 damage instead of 22, yes. And then now I roll the strength saving throw.
Yeah, do it, come on.
Boop.
Oh nice. God, yes!
Alright, you succeed. So barely up, this enormous creature just tries to stomp at you. But you block with the canopic edge, and you find that it is surprisingly and incredibly powerful, able to hold off this entire weight of this creature. Justin.
Ah, alright, so I stand up, losing half of my movement, and then I'm going mayhem on this fucker again. He had 10 feet less of his movement because of the canopic edge as well, but I guess it didn't matter. Yes. When he went for a strike. So that's I don't think I'm blessed anymore, so that's a 14 to hit on the first attack.
Okay, 14 would miss.
Fucker. And
be blessed. Isn't Aurora the one who blessed you?
Yeah, but we're not blessed anymore. I need to turn it off. Okay. He lost concentration when he got 48 points of damage or something.
Okay.
Yeah, Aurora got stomped.
So that's another 13.
Okay. So both myth.
Nice how I went mayhem on this fucker. So I'm going to pop the potion of speed with my bonus action, and that gets me another action, right?
Yes.
Right. So let's make a token. That's a potion. So I don't think there's concentration required when I get hit, but after 10 rounds, I'll suffer the consequences and be stunned. So,
yes.
Jeff and DM, is another attack action with the haste just one attack? Or is it two attacks again?
No, it's one attack.
Right.
With the haste.
Alright, so that's 21 to hit. And then 13 slashing, magical, and 10 psychic.
Oh, alright, he takes the full 23 points of damage. He is wounded, he makes a sort of strange roar that exhales this powder that smells of just sulfur, surprisingly.
Sulfur?
Yes.
Sulfur, yes.
Lol, are you giving me hints, mate? I could have shot them the whole time and they just explode?
Mew.
Oh yeah, let's see. She's already enlarged and stuff, no?
Is she two times?
He has not transformed into a dragon, no.
No. Okay, so Garcia enlarged three from three total. I don't. An extra attack. Okay, so she have normally two attacks, right? I see from here. Man, there is so much stuff. Yeah, we just get then two hits with the Warhammer she does normally, and then a shield bash, right? That's her normal thing.
It's two attacks, I think.
Okay, so normally she makes one attack and then...
No, two attacks and then shield bash. Three in total.
Yeah, okay. So, Warhammer one-handed, I guess. One.
Yeah.
And I will hit the big guy, of course, in front of her. 31.
Okay, so, and this one hits. It's also with advantage, so that is a total of 9 bludgeoning damage.
I don't know what the radiant is.
All right, I don't know. I'm gonna take it as 10 points of damage. The creature is barely alive, but still holding on.
Okay, so another hit with the Warhammer.
Yeah, and then you can shield bash the fucker behind you.
Okay. No. Yeah.
He is on command of myself. I won't hit him. So, again, 15 damage.
Oh, these ones.
And that kills this creature.
Okay, very good. Then Miru will move next to Mist.
Okay.
And shield bash him.
Okay.
With 27. Or well, she's not blessed at either, but.
Okay, yeah. A 26 would hit, so that is a total of. Well, 14 points of damage.
Yeah, and that would be it, I guess.
Okay, this one is stunned, so it's Orba's turn.
Okay. Some spell slots left, so.
Don't hit these with the faces. They are turned in mass suggestion. They will help us. I turned them.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So then he will throw a bomb. And he'll put the container on it, so it'll only hit the enemy. Does he throw one bomb only, or
Think he can throw two bombs. I'm not sure, though.
When did it get to two bombs? Oh, God. No.
Alright, we'll say now that it's one bomb, then. Okay,
yeah,
so
it's
he
one
will
bomb. Throw with a 17. And he's going to this one, again, the one fighting Jastin. No, because that's the only one he sees that's not under mass suggestion.
Alright, okay.
That's
all right.
29 points of fire damage to them.
29 points of fire damage, okay. They take all of that damage.
Did it react with the sulfur?
It did not, no.
Okay.
Alright, is that Orba's turn?
For a bonus action, he will drink a spider climbing potion. And for his movement, he will start to walk up the wall a bit.
Nice.
To get out of Battlemore. And if you allow it, this will be something like a stealth action as he tries to get away from the mass-suggested enemies walking to him.
Make a stealth check.
Distract a potion first. Alright. Okay.
He seems to be pretty stealthy. I mean, so far there's only two of these golems still active. So, that is Oraba's turn. Donado is going to shoot his enchanted hand cannon against
this. Ooh, nice.
It will crit, dealing a total of 20 piercing damage. And 11 fire, so a total of 31 points of damage.
Wait,
and then he will spend his.
There's 21 points of fire.
Reloading.
Isn't it 11 plus 10?
Yes, I calculated wrong. It's 41 points of damage total. Ooh. Okay. Wow. Alright, then he will spend his bonus action reloading the hand cannon. Now it is Martino De Calco who will he will give his boundless inspiration, so an 11 for Miru and Mist. So that's an 11 to hit and 2 damage.
Sweet.
On your next attack, Plato. And he will move over here.
Okay. Oh, this one is still dead. Oh. Good. It is almost over, right?
It is, yes.
I mean, the big creatures are like maybe 2 turns away if we don't roll good, but the mass suggested ones have all taken a lot of damage from the fireballs.
Well, they can regenerate in their turns. They are here to guard us and guide us through the tunnels. I will command my little mushrooms to hit the last standing mushroom golem.
Okay.
With a slash attack. Slash!
Okay. 2 of them left.
I have 2. Slash for 22 and for 19.
Both hit.
Okay. Attack. So 28 slashing damage.
Okay, 28 slashing damage. Then, what about your main turn?
I will move over here so I can see the golem. And I will casually cast Chill Touch. Oh man. It was a natural 1. I guess I won't hit with 11.
Okay. Alright, with a natural 1 on the Chill Touch, you accidentally hit the golem in front of you, making him no longer suggested towards you, but he is still paralyzed.
God. Okay, then I hope my shield will get it. What a reaction. How much did I move? 15. I could move another 15 feet back.
Maybe not next to that guy.
Yeah, I've just moved back. Oh shit! I misfired, guys! Fuck.
Oraba is roughly 25 feet up the wall, right? Mm. But I don't know how to show it, so he just stayed in the same spot.
Okay, that would be my turn.
He's up the wall. I'm gonna put that symbol. No. Okay, Mist, your turn.
Yeah, but this one can't regain hit points when it's his turn. Same thing with this one.
Well, yeah, because I attacked him.
Yeah.
Okay, that hits. How much damage was that?
8.
Okay, that is with the spiritual weapon, so it doesn't count yet the...
Yeah, it's just 6.
That's 6 points of force damage. Okay. All right, the creature is flanked, so that's a 30 and a 28, both hit. So that's 15 points of radiant, 11 points from the inspiration, and the second one is 13 points. Okay. All right, the creature is still alive. Barely so.
Is it for me?
Okay. It is going to regenerate 7 health at its turn, and it will turn to Miru and attempt to punch her twice.
Yeah, let's see the AC.
Punch with a 26.
Yeah, we'll hit.
That will hit. Okay, so that's 36 points of bludgeoning damage. And okay. Miru must make a strength saving throw. I believe she has advantage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you succeed on that. And he will do the wrecking punch again on Miru with an 11. Haunted. Missing her. Okay, these ones are stunned. So now it's the one near Justin. He is going to try to do the same thing as last time, doing the punch with a 21.
Yeah, fuck, I hit.
That is 33 points of bludgeoning halved, so that is 16. Make a strength saving throw.
Ooh!
Okay,
9. Fail. So I fall prone again.
You are pushed, fall prone, and he will pursue and attempt to stomp you again.
You said 18, right?
Yes.
Alright, 2.
He's going to move over here, and he is going to try to stomp you with a 22.
That hits as well. I make another strength throw. Don't suck too much. Alright. Yep. Can I make a DC 20? No, I cannot.
Shit.
So that's 9.
9 I bludgeoning. So that's 60 points of damage.
63, and then it's 60 again, right? No.
Yes.
No, it's 51 now. Don't lie to me.
Damage second stomp, so that's 51 force, 9 bludgeoning.
I have 12 left.
15, so that's a total of 76.
Right, I'm at 12. Oh no, because of the potion, my AC got higher by plus 2, right? It's the same as a haste spell. So I have a 21 AC.
He
still hits. All right.
The first one didn't, though.
Yeah, it's a 21. The first one was a 21.
Oh, damn. Never mind.
All right, Justin, your turn.
All right, I'll use my movement to get up. And then I'll try to go mayhem on him. No, I'm not mayhem cursed it. I go and slash him to bits. It's a 29.
29 so hits.
13 and 8 psychic.
Mm-hmm. Alright, 21 total.
So second one then, hit. Nice. So that's 11 plus 18 psychic. 29.
Creature is very close to dying, but it's still holding on.
Yeah, last attack. Haste. 24 haste to hit. Last.
And that hits. That is a total of 21 points of damage, and that fells the creature.
Nice. And with the last step, you see that I'll draw some of it into myself as I heal for my warlock level plus something. And that would be then my turn.
Ooh.
Hey.
What slashing.
All right. Miru.
Miru! Warhammer Bash 1. 17.
That would hit.
No. So,
that
17.
Does hit. So that is 17. Minus 11 because of the inspiration. Sorry, plus 11 damage for the inspiration. The creature is barely alive. One mortal tap will knock it over.
Okay, then she will crush its kind of big, bulky head with a warhammer.
Okay,
with his
with
swing.
It, the creature just falls and is shattered in two.
Okay.
Breaking apart completely.
So the last one is just behind her, so she turn around, make one fast step, and will hit the stunned golem with his shield bash.
Okay. That's an automated crit.
Considering that all of them are stunned, And this one is charmed. We could just hand wave this the rest of this fight and say that these three that are stunned just die. Because they'll still be stunned for 5 turns.
Could Jessen be the one to kill them? Because then I regenerate health.
Wait, I wouldn't kill them actually because they are in our control for 24 hours, guys. They are our servants now for 24 hours.
Did they break free of the spell?
No. They are now charmed. And will guide...
someone attack them, can they break free from the spell?
Yeah, when we attack them.
But if others, they can't.
Nope.
Well, then it's pretty useful.
Except they get dispelled, so, but that's not in my control.
We could counterspell a dispel.
Yeah.
Alright.
Okay, alright, so this one that is stunned, that was stunned by Miro's shield, will just be cut to pieces and destroyed.
Okay.
Can Jessen be the one to kill him, so I generated hate? Hello. Saves up health.
If no one else objects?
I don't.
Nice, brings me back to 38. Gosh.
Ooh. Guys, that was a hard fight. Are you all alright?
Yeah, are we alright? That fucking mushroom powder didn't work. They totally saw through it. And I look at the mushrooms who are charmed next to me. Well, they don't now, but that's your magic. And Oruba comes down from the ceiling.
Robin and Sasha, they are dead! Well, tomorrow they will come back.
Yeah, thanks. You were a bit too attached for them to just be a day old.
Okay, Henry, you carry Sasha. And you, Mara, you are carrying Sasha. Easy as that. So next day they will come back. And you will carry them. They come here. Just right next to me. Yeah, perfect. So, let's go. And you three guys, you will bring us. You will show us the way through the tunnels. Where do we want to go, actually? In the core? To the core?
Yeah, I guess further in to find the core and then blast it away. But we should... maybe we should take a short rest. And I look over to Oruba, look down on me. My left arm's still just hanging.
I could do that. Actually, we should move these corpses to one location and burn them to the ground so they won't get to, well, reanimate like my little mushroom.
Oh, I noticed something. The clouds have sulfur in them, so I guess they're easy to burn.
Easy.
Someone has a cantrip fire?
No, sorry. I'm not the fire guy, actually. I'm more like chill touch, mending.
Okay, then no would have sufficed, you know. I look at Martino and Donato. Any of you guys know a fire cantrip? Otherwise, we just use our fire stones.
Yeah, I mean, I can always raging spirit them away. Disintegrate them in this case. But I would do it in the corner right there. Just okay, somebody right. Has to move them in the corner there.
Donato will use his spell called the Fire of the Forges, his cantrip, and will set these creatures on fire.
Oh, cool.
You find that there is a shirking from the mushrooms themselves that surround you, as if they are afraid of it.
They should be.
Well, now that we've drawn the attention of the whole Mushroom City, we should progress or maybe take the rest now.
Yeah, and I guess.
And I sit down, and while taking my rest or starting my rest, I suffer a short stun since the potion wears off.
Yeah. So it dies 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, nice. 5, 10, 16, 30, 39, something.
Arthur is going to, Oraba is going to roll a bunch of hit points too. Alright, let's see.
17, 24, 31, 37, 7, 8, 8, 10, 7, 28, 32. Dann kann ich noch 4 weitere. 1, 2, 3, 4. 25. 8. 9. 39. Okay, almost. Almost. Almost at full.
Same for Oraba. And he still has hit points, hit dice left. And now Justin. That's the thing where warlocks really shine. Okay, nice. So it starts with a 6, 12, 17.
I have 0 arcane recovery. Good to know.
Right, nice. And Justin regains all his spell slots. And his action search tab.
How many spells do we have?
Only 2.
Already 2.
Yeah, that's Warlock's fate. You have you don't have many, but short resting gets you everything back.
Yeah.
And it's quite nice because fighters have the same features with some things, like second wind. Action search, and later on the domination dice that you could take also correspond with a short rest. Short rest kings.
That's cool.
Yep. But that took Justin how many rolls did I make? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So he has 5 hit dice left. Right, so Oraba is missing 2 health and Justin is missing 8 health to regain full.
Miro 12.
Alright, nice.
Okay.
Guys, I'm very happy that I didn't get hit, because otherwise I would be like smashed into pieces. They have really big feet that would stomp me like, I don't know, like a nut from an elephant.
Your level plus charisma modifier. Right, so Oraba is going to also use inspiring medicine, which he can do during the short rest, and he goes around and treats everyone's wounds and applies some potions to enhance everyone, so they get temporary hit points equal to his level plus his charisma modifier, which is 2 plus 14, so 16 temporary hit points for everyone as well.
Oh, nice.
Because it doesn't 16. Have a limit. Yeah, he just needs 10 minutes and he can choose any creature. Choose, no, up to 6 friendly creatures, which would be our team, 5, plus one of the vampires and the weaker one, the approachable one. What's his name again? Martino.
Chicago.
Yeah, it's not holy ointments or something, it's just herbs and stuff.
Oh, Ryza.
Hey, Ryza! Hey. She lives.
Sorry, guys.
Maybe. Don't worry, we got through combat. We made it as well.
Nobody died.
Nope. Yeah, nobody died. It was close, though.
That's good.
16. Hello, Ryza.
Sorry. I'm here.
Chris played you for the combat.
I got more things to open now because I got an additional feature.
Yeah, I used all your hit dice to regain your hit points in the short rest. You are pretty down. Now you're at 179 hit points and 16 temporary HP. You have a lot of abilities and feats. That's sick.
I need to read through them because I forget things for like a few, like 10 sessions later I realize something. Oh, wait, I can do that.
Yeah.
That one.
I played Aura by the last 2 sessions and now I got mad at myself because I didn't notice he had sorcery points.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
Yeah, he's a
Yeah, I could have quickened spell and stuff.
Yeah, he's meta magic.
I don't think he remembers that one also though.
No, he does. He does bonus action, bless us, and then attack still. That's why I had the idea that he could throw 2 bombs. It wasn't that. It
oh was yeah, that he can throw 2 quickened, bombs, yes.
He quickened spell.
Yeah. Oh, meta magic, so fun.
Right, so now we're taking a short rest. Jastin is going to be also on the lookout with his observant feet to see if anyone's coming up in the corridor.
Let me roll some dice then to heal.
Okay.
Oh, I already did.
Are we healed or no?
Yeah, you used.
I used all the hit dice.
I used all the hit dice.
Yeah, I...
Dying?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you were pretty down at 65 or so, so you really needed it.
I'm still fine.
Yeah, it is still fine, actually. With 74, you are in the range of Klaatu's health.
Yeah, like it's still fine. Okay, let me read through again all the things.
Okay, all right. With your during your short rest, nothing really happens aside from these mushroom wizards waking up from their stupor and still being suggested following. The procedure then to just approach over here and remain in a defensive position. What you do find, Klaatu, is that the spell that holds over them does start to wane. Because of the mushroom's connection to other minds.
Oh, yeah. There is
a certain weakness to them. Like, you find that your enchantment is holding less strength over the course of the short rest.
So I think that it won't hold for 24 hours.
It is unlikely that it will hold for the for that amount of time.
Okay. Oh, guys, you remember me saying that they will get to show the way for 24 hours? I think I misjudged that a little bit. So, because they are half minds, they get connected with all the mushrooms, and that's really hard to hold off right now. And I think the spell will, work perhaps a few hours, not the full 24, as I estimated.
Alright, so maybe we kill two of them now and then let one of them guide us.
Yeah, perhaps. Could be the safer way.
Let's all get ready to stab at him.
Yeah.
Poor thing.
Maybe you suggest that he gets in the middle of us. Let's make a circle. Everyone's 5 feet of him and then we just stab.
Yeah.
Just so
Mushroom Mancer 1, please come in the middle to us.
Oh no.
Alright, he is compelled to do so as per his suggestion.
Mir's feeling really uncomfortable with this one.
It's like cutting vegetables. Don't worry about it.
He's not fighting. He doesn't want to fight.
No, but he's already fighting. Don't forget that everything you breathe here is not good for you and trying to take control of you. So I need to remind you as I point at my mask. Alright, so 3, 2, 1.
All attack. I use skill touch, so he can't regenerate.
Alright, there's no need for that. You just all gank on him and
it's like a prisoner's shanking movie scene.
we just
shank that fucker.
You can see that she's like really
She's carrying a blunt weapon, so she has to smash him to death.
She's like doing it. You can see that she's like doing it not as hard as she usually does.
All right, that was one. So Mancer 2,
please come here. Nothing to worry about.
It's going to make you stronger, Mira.
Really
want to
hit something that doesn't look right.
You do the countdown, Miru.
Miru's like closing her eyes with her hands.
That is especially cool.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Yep.
There you go.
He is cut all over. He is cut all over, dies again. And you find that actually there are some mushroom pieces that look like they could be eaten.
Ooh.
Like I said, vegetables.
I wouldn't eat this stuff.
Doesn't eat anything that speaks.
We have to burn them, don't forget it. Please, Donatello?
Donato.
Donato, right.
I heard of a turtle named Donatello.
Right. Oops. Oh, it's an old children's book I read. I forgot. It's about three little turtles get involved in a massive spell work accident and getting like human form. Very, well, it's very childish, but they love this bread. Bread with tomato sauce on it. It's very nice. Nice idea.
I cannot believe that you found a way to properly put that into the game.
It's now part of the...
It's not part
it
of
is
canon.
It's canon, yes.
Yeah.
If it's a children's book, Miro might know it.
Yes, probably. It's very famous in Vanuta.
Oh my god.
It But we used to, like, kill to closing your eyes.
Okay, what do you do? What do you do with the last one?
He will guide us through the tunnels for as long as I fear the connection.
Okay, all right.
Perhaps I will guide.
You'll have to make an arcana check to maintain your control over it.
Yes. I fail, I use my luck points. But okay. 22 right. Looks good.
He seems to be kept well under control.
Yeah, very good. So I will try to tell him to use passages of the underground that are not guarded or empty, where he can feel no presence of his hive.
Okay.
Or it can't.
All right. He speaks to you, having apparently learned a language, and says,
"You will have to pass the fortress and its defenses, but I can open the gates to you."
Oh, that would be nice, actually. Which kind of dangers is awaiting us behind the gate? Like traps, or more like more of your guardians?
Fungal mancers, more powerful than I am.
Scary. Did you hear that, guys?
Something gate. Shouldn't we ask him if there's a smaller door to avoid the, what did he say, fungal masters?
The fortress. I guess we have to go there. Or I inside check him.
Sure,
well,
you can inside.
That's my proficiency, but we will see. Well, I believe him. Why should he lie? He's under my spell. I don't know why I'm concerned.
You concerned?
I think he's telling the truth. We must go through the fortress to get to the core. It's only logical that the fortress is the core, probably.
Well, I'll ask him about the weaknesses.
Well, it's fire and cold, I guess. What are the weaknesses of you guys? It's fire and cold, right? You hate it.
Cold and blight damages us all, but not the powerful fungal mancers.
Why do they adapt to this kind of, well, harsh environments?
They are our most precious. They are the most precious servants of our community. They must be protected.
Oh, ask what form they have.
Yeah, what form they have? Why is that important for you?
They have the form of. They have our form, and they carry the Staff of Power.
Oh, Staff of Power? Do I heard about this? Can I make a history or arcana check?
Make a history check. History or arcana, yes.
Nice. To answer your question, Klaatu, I asked this because I feared that they have might have overtaken something like a big creature. Slaves right. There. Enslave them, and that's what's waiting for us.
Oh, yeah. So 19 for power, Staff of Power. History.
There is something familiar about these staffs. All of them seem to have a core part, like a core shard
of that same staff of that the mushroom girl had when you met her.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. So there is a very strong essence of that. Of that girl's power, but she was significantly stronger than these are.
Oh, interesting. So perhaps she is also a better form of them.
Fungal magician master guy.
Please, can you give me your staff? Can you borrow it to me for, I don't know, a long time? Like forever?
My staff would serve you. He gives you the staff.
Oh, thank you.
Be careful.
And as he gives you the staff, he starts slowly withering away.
Oh,
and reverting to the form of your phallids.
Oh, sweet. Okay.
Pass this thing to one of your servants, please.
Oh, yes. And I will pass the Staff of Power to Henry. He deserves it. He's the firstborn.
And I pull the pepper box and point it at Henry.
Hey!
Hi! The staff might make him connect to the hive.
Well, make also.
Make an arcana check, Plato. Mm-hmm.
I have my detect magic on, and since I'm concerned, maybe I'm helping.
It is, yes, okay. This is definitely transforming Henry into one of these creatures. Mm. However, he is slipping very rapidly out of your control.
Oh, shit. Nope.
All right, I noticed something. You better take that staff away again.
Yep, I do. Nope, that's not for you, Henry, sorry. Cancel the evolution. Press B. Press B to cancel. I don't want it, Gyarados. I'm cool. All right. Okay,
well, you successfully cancel the evolution. And, okay. You hold the staff. You recognize the staff's power as it attacks your hand. Make a constitution saving throw.
Mm-hmm. Ah, damn, I wanted to say that I just don't touch it with my skin. But yeah. Okay, constitution 20!
Right. Okay, you succeed. You are able to hold it. It does seem to give an incredibly intense fungal mancy power to the wielder, essentially serving as a sort of upgrade or evolution. Perhaps exposure to these was what also turned them into these mushroom monsters. So there seems like all of these creatures, all of these fungus, are born from these thallids that are your servants and then can actually be upgraded depending on the contact with this staff.
Or whatever in it.
Yes.
Can I confer with Legion for a moment and ask if we were able to sever the connection between the staff and the hive? Putting like something of us in between to interrupt the connection, or maybe even absorbing the thing that is responsible for the connection?
Okay, all right. Make a history check with advantage because you're consulting Legion.
There's actually a thing that I can now do. It's called Mind of Legion. So I it makes me roll. All right, no, I don't need that. I just get expertise on the check related to it. So I gain double my proficiency.
All right. In this case, you would also get advantage.
And what did you say? What check?
It would be Arcana or History.
All right. Let's go with that, and it's an additional, what, plus 4? Plus 5 now, proficiency is plus 5. Oh. 22.
So that's 22. All right, with the 22 in history, you find that the Legion has a fungal creature within.
Ooh. So do I get the idea that I could hijack the system with putting...
You find yourself appearing before this fungal creature. It seems to take a bow at you, as its head strangely almost splits into 5 or more different heads, different, mm-hmm. as if there is almost a sub-hive within Legion.
In my mind, I begin laughing, and I go over to Klaatu, and I take the canopic etch out, say, don't worry, I'm trying something out, and I'll take the tip of it and point it at the staff and try to interject the signal by putting this fella of us in between and gaining control of the signal, linking it to the sub mind.
Okay.
Just stabilize me, Klaatu.
There is a struggle, and ultimately, it succeeds. This creature turns into one of the normal phallids. And, Klaatu, you find that your suggestion is overpowered by some sort of dispel magic effect that takes over this thing.
Mm-hmm. Oh, careful, Jessen, behind you is now an enemy.
Ah, fuck.
It says to you, to Justin, in Infernal,
oh.
We are Legion.
I look at Klaatu and say, oh, don't you worry, everything worked out just fine.
Do I know Infernal? Oh, I know Infernal, so I heard it. Oh, well, I heard that. You put Legion in that?
I put a part of us in there, so it disrupts the connection to the hive. You're welcome. Oh,
so can you turn it off again? I want to study
You should be able to pass on the staff now.
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
But then you will be like... I'm not ready to be not the mother of Henry.
Oh, what the fuck? Don't be childish like that. I helped you do that.
Well, whatever. Give it to me. Give me the stuff.
There you go.
Thanks. So, Henry, here. Perhaps you get a new employee.
Okay, you give it to Henry then?
Yeah. Let's try it.
Okay. All right. Okay. Make an intelligence check.
Mm-hmm.
Destin already overseeing this as well. Oh, helping along, rather.
17.
All right. You're able to keep control of this.
Okay. Just saying.
And you get your own soothsayer.
Oh, crazy.
There we go. Using the enemy's weapons against them. Good thinking, Klaatu.
That is really...
Let me one second.
Mm-hmm.
Let me duplicate this one. Right. Where is Klaatu's stuff?
I'm eating something that's so delicious. Oh my god.
Actually, if you want to, you can delete Klaatu in brackets Bart and copy of Klaatu Ferrat.
That's okay. Right.
No, I don't need that either. Oh, nice. Tell it to Thea. Thea. Ooh.
Okay. All right. Wow. You have now Henry as a soothsayer. He has evolved.
Nice. Henry's a second. Oh, I don't have control over him right now. Not yet.
Yes. If you want to order each spell, you have to spend your bonus action on their specific spell that you want us, that you want them to cast.
Mm-hmm. So you mean like normally I use my bonus action to control all my minions? You say now if I want to make a spell, I specifically use my bonus action to command this one, Henry the Second, to cast a spell.
Yes, exactly.
Yes, okay. Got it.
So you can command all of them to attack. If you command all of them to attack, they will just do their regular attacks, clubs and slashes and, you know, stuff like that.
And they would progress doing it in the next turns. And when so first turn, I would order them to attack. Second turn, bonus action, I would like say to Henry the Second, cast this or this spell.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Yes. Interesting. Ooh. Ooh.
Right, come on, we will guide you. And I look at the phallid.
Okay. Alright, this phallid over here will guide you, he says. Legion will guide you.
Yeah.
And he proceeds forward. You find yourselves walking.
Ooh.
It is a surprisingly long tunnel. You pass over as the darkness starts thickening in the tunnel. You find that the tunnel is actually alit with some bioluminescent spores and fungi, creating different sorts of colors. But at the same time, you get the impression that you are being watched.
In my head, I go, are we being watched? Do you pick up the conversations of the other mushrooms?
Response will be, all this lives together as one, just as we are one.
So there won't be a surprise element. I think they know that we're coming, guys. I'm pretty sure.
Still disguised? Like them?
Well, they might not know who's in front of them as they see us, but they sense what we do. So, even though they can open the gates for us, afterwards it'll be fights. Or should we just burn the whole place down? Because it is a tunnel system. If we just make enough fire, they're bound to come out to us.
I think that we might... Or that we can get it in an easier way if we find the core that make these staffs of power. If we can grab like the source of this and disrupt it, they will turn to this little talents. That will be an easy task to get rid of.
But we need to get to through the fortress to get to the core.
Yeah, I guess that's what the little guy told us.
Can you check if they're talking about us? You are controlling one, right? Can you ask?
I don't want to delve in its conscious, but I in my mind I go what are they? Yeah, he can, so we can, but it takes a toll. So I'd rather just ask it questions. I ask questions.
Okay, all right. What questions do you ask?
Little Talid, is there a great source of where you get these stuffs from? Is there, like, I don't know, a big stone, a big mineral that gives you power and you harvest for these stuffs? Where do you get these from?
The staffs grow from... The staffs grow from the remnant, from that which has been left here.
So perhaps if we get rid of that, or so?
Sounds more like we should use it. Powerful things just growing here. Let's get rid of the mushrooms and harvest them ourselves.
Wow. Okay.
Or maybe it's going to give the people here a chance to sustain themselves afterwards. Because those mushrooms have infected most of the river. Don't forget about that.
Oh no.
They are enslaving people and probably consuming them at some point later. Parasitic mushrooms they are.
Well, isn't that, and I look at Aura, isn't that like nature and stuff? Yeah, it is. Oh, thanks, Auraba.
I'll find it to be a bit unnatural. Natural would be if they have their own free will.
Well, there are actually really mushrooms in the normal nature which are doing this. So I think they are just bigger versions. A little bit more dangerous, but well, there are also spiders who can poison you to death.
I also don't like and would kill.
Oh man, well, I just wouldn't live there. But that's another topic, I guess. So yeah, probably a lot of fighting in the fortress. And if we really want to burn this all, I mean, how do you want to do this? How much gunpowder do you have to do this? We need a massive explosion.
I was thinking about magic.
Yeah, I have a few raging spirits I can do, but it's not like I'm a big fire mage.
Maybe if we just burn the thing that they said that was growing the stuffs, we don't have to burn the whole thing, right?
The whole
cave.
Quick thinking.
I guess we'll see when we get there.
We just have to be very careful, like, you know, that we don't get caught.
I think we will get caught, and I think we will need to kill a lot more mushrooms. We may be getting there through secret passages and everything, but once we're at the gate, there's only going to be one entrance, and that is through the gate.
But we have these mushroom pieces here. If we can try it now. I wrap myself in some of these mushroom peoples of the dead soothsayer. And go to the little Talid. Can you perceive me as one of you, of one of your kind? Or am I still an enemy in your sight? Or better,
To me, no.
Okay. Yeah, because you're a leech. That's bad.
Sure, you need what?
Well, I don't think that we necessarily count as enemy if we are like them. If we have the same aura or like the same smell,
well, they didn't work before.
Off, but we are not like off-putting and enemies in the first place. They are like, the same, like mimicry.
Or to behave the same as well. Well, I thought when that big guy looked at me, I'm fucked. And then it hurt pretty much.
He just attacked you, actually, in the first round. Or in the first seconds. He was not, like, attacking us all.
Maybe you need more rubbing of this the cup. And then Mira's, like, starting to rub your hand. Or maybe you didn't have enough.
All right, maybe let's try that again. And we'll see at the gate. But everyone, I don't go first anymore. And I will attack first again.
Yes.
That screws up for everyone.
Oh, that's totally good.
How my instincts work.
If one of our little chain... what's a gleet? chain part will break. We will all fight, so... It was a right choice to do, actually.
Okay. After walking for about 2 hours, you find yourselves before this great structure, this living, breathing organism that opens its mouth wide and then closes to allow little phthalates to pass by.
Oh.
Some of these creatures come to you, and you find that they leave this place, even some soothsayers, and they just seem to just pass you by.
Uh-huh.
Donato prepares his hand cannon, but it seems as if nothing comes, nothing is triggered.
I see it.
So in we go.
You find as well that there are some cracks below. There is a chasm, a great bridge that leads to this enormous opening, this enormous thing, this great fungus. And there seems to be nothing but darkness below.
Can Miru use plant speak and check if the mushrooms are saying anything or anything in this area is saying anything?
Okay, sure. You can try to open your mind to them, but make a wisdom check.
Wisdom check. Wait. Just a pure wisdom check, right?
Yes.
They do talk a lot, don't they? Ooh, three.
There is a cacophony of their noises. A lot of them are speaking at the same time.
Do I at least?
And you find yourself only with this enormous question, this booming voice that seems to almost assault your head with enormous and terrible headaches. It says, "What do you wish?"
Okay. Do I know where it's coming from? Or no?
You do not. No, not with this wisdom. Okay. It's just assaulting you from all over the place. But at the same time, nowhere really in particular. It's...
Okay.
Strange, scary sort of thing.
Okay. Mira just stops listening to them and says, I was trying to see if we could find any information about that one, but they're very chatty. And they seem like they are very open to things you want. For something that's connected, like you said, like, you know, like connected to each other's minds, they do seem to take importance on what you want.
What did you hear them say?
Like, it was asking me. Well, it wasn't asking me, but it was there was a lot of noises, you know, lots of noises. Like, you know, when you're in the port where there's a lot of people talking, like hundreds of them, like very, very loud. And then you know, when they ask you, like in a really loud voice, what you want. Like, yeah, I mean, there were a lot of noises, but that one was very loud.
Are you sure that wasn't directed at you?
I mean, they wouldn't know I was listening, right? I mean, I'm listening through my ears, not through my head.
Right, but to listen to them, they don't talk. So, did you use... I don't know. It's confusing to me.
It's not magic.
Well, try answering.
Sorry, can you repeat that?
If you answer it and it replies, then you know it was directed at you.
I don't know. There were a lot of voices, though. I don't know if they could hear me.
Well, ask with your mouth.
And then if I shout, they might know that we're not the same kind.
Well, here's the thing. We know that we're listening at the same time. And look at the fellet that's walking in front of me. So I'm pretty sure that they are talking, listening, feeling, and everything at the same time, since they're all connected.
I can ask, but like I said, it's not magic. I just can understand them with my ears. And not through my head, like the one that Klaatu does, where we can talk in our head. That's weird also. I mean, what do we need? I mean, what do I need? I mean, we wanna go to where the staffs are?
No. Maybe ask it that, or tell it that you want to see what the castle is like.
Oh, they have a castle? I thought they had a fortress.
Oh, fortress, castle. Yeah, you're asking what the fortress is like.
Okay, but are you sure it's really okay to shout here? Well, they might attack us.
Don't just speak normally. Normal voice. Because I think the walls here are listening to you as well. You don't need to scream.
I will try. Miro tries again. Concentrate listening if she hears that same voice.
Okay. The same voice is present. It seems to be ever-present, almost commanding all of these little voices that speak to you at the same time, but in quite indiscernible sounds. You really cannot understand at all what it says.
Okay, so all the party sees is Miru whispering, I want to go to the fortress. I want to go to the fortress. where the things are. Fortress, the fortress.
Okay. Miru. You hear the voice reply to you. And it says, you are not one of us. You have left us. Why do you seek to return?
Because I want to come back?
Good answer.
door opens. The whole thing opens, contracting some sort of strange, almost muscle that it has. And you find yourself in this place that has an architecture of its own. It has been built. There are stones that have been set here. But it speaks of a culture much more ancient than these fungoids, almost as if they have grown in this culture's absence. There are holes both from the bottom and to the top, and you find that you don't really know how much you have descended, but you know that you have walked a while.
Ooh.
We're seeing a black screen, by the way.
Mm. Yes, I know. Revealing this. You have walked this path downwards, and you have reached the fortress.
Okay.
100 different noises, hundreds, thousands of different voices suddenly overtake your little guide, and from one moment to the next, it is gone.
Oh, the guide me or the guide? Well, there was only guide me, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Is our connection severed?
It seems to be. But right. You can still try to make a connection to it.
Nah, before I lose the soul, I'll take it back. But I'll try to do as much damage as I can.
Okay.
I'm like, send wrong commands.
Refusing to be taken back.
Oh.
Make an arcana check.
Mm-hmm.
Can I help him?
Oh.
We have the
better
telepathic bond.
You are not connected to it, though.
No,
but you have not connected to it before.
I'm connected to Justin, but what?
I cannot say so.
Okay.
Yeah,
you feel a backlash of this, Justin, and you feel as if you have inadvertently done the opposite, allowed more souls to travel to it, as almost as if part of Legion's mind has jumped to it. The souls remain with Legion, but the mind seems to roam free.
Ah.
And Legion speaks to you, saying, "We have been granted an obedient body."
We have been granted an obedient body. Well, I don't think we'll be able to retrieve them. They'll be lost, they'll be put to use. But once we get to the core, we'll be rewarded for everything. Don't worry about it. But that was some crazy strong pull.
You find at a fortress that there are these different creatures, different and significantly more advanced beings of power, and they show a lot more power with their staffs. They glow significantly in the dark, almost as if to guide all of the other Thalids to them. And you find almost as if this is some sort of keeper of these Thalids, a shepherd, perhaps. One of them approaches you and says, "The many welcome you. You who have straggled off, but have returned. Why have you returned?
Is it looking at Miru, or is it looking at everybody?
It's looking at everyone, but it's hard to say exactly where it is looking at.
Yeah.
No, you know, just as life has to spread out and grow from a young seedling into a full-grown tree or mushroom and then come back to fulfill its cycle, so have we.
Really?
I don't fucking know.
It says, your mind reveals hostile intentions, but you have passed the gate. What are you?
Must surely be only the contempt I hold for being kept from my true meaning, which is to go further into the fortress and find the truth within our greatest treasures.
All that are here are willing. None are here because of meaning. There is no meaning here. Only togetherness. You do not seek togetherness, for you are not together with your group.
I go and take some steps closer to my group.
Do we have the mind connection thingy?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You do have the mind connection.
Oh, okay.
We are in the inner circle.
Because Mir's gonna say, what is he saying?
Well, he doesn't trust us and he wants to know which kind we are, which group we are, if we are with them or not. I don't know. Do we want to approach like out front enemies? I would try to. I could. Well, I have one idea I could use, but.
Like, can't we tell them like we have a different but want to visit? Like relatives, you know, visiting.
Yeah, let's go for that, since everything I said didn't work.
Okay, Miru, make a deception check then.
Deception, oh boy. 18.
Nice.
You know, we've separated, but we were part of this group, and we want to know what's happening now, and we want to connect again. We're just like looking around while you're saying this. Is it working? Kind of look.
Okay. He says, you are not fully of us, but you are more of us than they are.
This is all very cryptic.
Your false smell erodes. Do you serve she who is our enemy?
Can I get it now?
I don't think we serve anyone. She wants to say that.
No,
we serve no one but ourselves.
The fact that didn't we use the mushroom hat of the other group? You know, the one that says they were going to be controlled. So, yeah.
Yeah, that could be.
That's why they think we're in a different group. But at the same time, same family.
I think this shepherd is just able to see through our disguise, mostly.
No, I think it thinks we're mushrooms from the other group.
Oh, yeah, that could be.
Because we use the mushroom head of the other group, that you know, the one that gave us. Mm. Maybe we should have used another mushroom head. Too late.
Yeah, a whole mixture of smells. Must be confusing for them. We are serving just ourselves. I say to the mushroom.
Make a persuasion check.
Yeah.
No, wait. It's a normal persuasion. I don't flirt with him. Not yet. It's an 8. Well,
I think it's past the shepherd mate.
Well, wait. I will make I use one of my luck points because at some points I probably will want to flirt with him. So let's make him a 19.
Nice.
Okay, all right. Did you say you do
only serve yourself, little beauty?
Fungus, an asexual being, does not understand what you have said. It says,
"Are they trying to flirt with the mushroom?"
They did. Yes. Yes.
Not yet.
And don't say not they, yet. Please, Chris.
Says, if you are here to visit alone and serve yourself only and do not wish to join us, go right towards the city and may their presence convince you to join forces with us. You may enter.
Interesting.
But wear your magics here, necromancer.
Ooh. Oh, I won't use that. It's all right. I won't do any harm. We are cool if you are cool.
We know your form.
And the
fungal mancers would wish to speak to you. But first, they would wish to show you what we seek to protect.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Nice. Yeah. I'm curious.
In my mind, I go, that's the thing we want to blow up, right?
Yeah, well, yes. But we don't know. Better. I'm really curious, actually. I want to see it.
Maybe ask when the fungal masters will arrive.
When do we get picked up for that? Perhaps we
After you have seen enough to be convinced.
All right. Please take us there.
He goes with you, walking, is using his staff much like a shepherd's cane. He seems to talk to you. And he says, we know that you are the ones who destroyed the first defenses. Why did you do so?
Well, you know the environment here. It's very harsh, and sometimes it's be eaten or get eaten. And we were on the brink of not knowing what's happening. You welcomed us here very nice, and I, for my part, I wouldn't do so again, of course. Not unless you give me other, well,
You changed my opinion about that.
You unfortunately do not speak for your group.
Well, I attacked them because I thought they would attack me.
I trust more you and your power, Necromancer. Sorry, what was that? What was that, Justin?
Oh, he then, as he says, he doesn't talk for the party, says that he just attacked before he attacked because he thought he would be attacked.
We are not the savage creatures you think of us as.
Well, but you keep slaves.
I think we will see in the city.
There are no slaves among us. Only those that have connected to our common mind.
Forcefully subjected.
I have a name. Oh. I am Poprinus.
Poprinus?
You would find that there are those. You will find that there are other types of minds where there is no single names. But we all have names here.
Oh.
We all choose to be here.
Hmm. We ran into a tabaxi on the way here who was pretty much very happy to escape from your influence.
It is easy to lose oneself in the influence of the one mind.
Yeah, there you have it then. Sounds unjust.
But the one mind is a blessing. We do not judge those that have fled, nor will we forcefully keep them here.
But if they breathe in the spores on their way out or drink something out of the river and get back, I mean, who cares, right?
We have only done what we have to the river to defend ourselves against the queen, for she attacks us without mercy, seeks to destroy us without reprieve.
What queen?
What queen?
The queen of the plants. Who sends her armies against us.
Yeah.
Our numbers must grow. Our numbers must grow so we remain free. It is not our wish to be at war with her.
That's good to hear, actually.
She does not understand that we may live for each other and not against each other. She has been plagued, her mind corrupted, and we have done much to attempt to purge her of her post.
What has corrupted her? You know, if you could put a pin on it.
We do not know, nor do we seek to care for it. She is a threat, and the threat must be dealt with and destroyed.
Was she a friend before? She
has allowed creatures to bloom and prosper.
Well, that is true.
She was always our friend, and we were hers.
In my mind, I address Mist and say, "Do you want to maybe look this all over again, check with your goddess? Because now it sounds weird. Although it'd be pretty clear that we need to get rid of them."
Well, wasn't there
Miss?
Like,
did you respond? I'm sorry, I'm my internet was flaky for a moment.
No, I didn't hear the response.
Okay.
I'm sorry, what are you looking for from me?
We got to know that the queen hates the mushrooms, and we were pretty sure that Melora wanted us to kill the mushrooms, right?
No, she wants
well,
to
deal with them. I don't know.
Kill, deal with them.
Kill wasn't the word she would use.
Well, now we got to know that the queen was friends with the mushrooms before, and that they were trying to get rid of her corruption, but she has overpowered them and driven them here. That's why they put up the self-defenses and corrupted everything around them to recover. So, do we really want to, you know, wipe them all out?
I don't think so. They seem very reasonable. Sorry to interrupt. Your thoughts?
No, everyone's opinions, really, but you know, it's another Melora mission, and you're the head of the helm there.
Well, that's right.
They're kind of corrupting everything, aren't they? I mean, not just... I mean, we saw people with their corrupted by them, and I mean, they're like corrupting the entire water supply.
Yeah, it looked very black and white, but now it looks very gray. That's what I'm telling you.
Yeah, Mateus is really good at that.
Mm. Well, that's black, I mean.
We were like, yeah, that's black.
You're going to have you question your decision.
Yeah. Because well, now it seems like maybe we get to know more about the queen's corruption and maybe how to rid her of it. And that could what been what we've actually been here to do.
Yeah, I would suppose we see the city and ask, or investigate the city and ask the... Well, you don't see it, but in my mind I do question marks and quotes. The corrupted people.
Yeah, but also, they're showing us the core now, and then we have to choose if we want to blow it up or not, you know? Because that's the... I mean, it's not going to get better. They're going to actually lead us there. It's just him and us.
That's all right. I think we can talk it over in the city. I will keep the inner circle. I will refresh it every 45 minutes. So, let's see the city, I guess. Right?
Sure.
Okay.
Honestly, I don't know what to do.
Yeah, I would say
I guess
so.
Need more information then to make a decision. So let's get more information.
Yes.
Sounds like a plan.
You walk through tunnels that wind about, that twist and turn, and follow these great fungal growths that have reached deep, deep into the earth. And you, at some point, finally reach what he has called the Myconid City. It is a grand city with perhaps thousands, tens of thousands of different myconids, not actually thalids, but different creatures altogether. I'm going to show you the three different ones, just so you can kind of see them.
Mm-hmm.
From little what?
Hello.
From little sprouts, such as these, that crawl on the earth, to adults that walk, to sovereigns that seem to mostly lay about, like perhaps grumpy old men, that smoke some strange form of fumes that comes from deep beneath the earth. That smell of sulfur is definitely stronger here.
Oh,
but
do I get the idea
seem
that
to be
it's...
happy. Being around almost. Sorry, they run around almost like, in some cases, the sproutlings run like children chasing each other in packs, with adults watching over them. A strange dynamic, as they share still a sort of hive mind. But in these cases, it seems quite different. One of the adults approaches and says, "I greet you, Coprinus. I am Cremini. And who are our guests?" Minos turns and says, "These are creatures from outside of the jungle." Yes, it is Coprinus with a C.
Okay.
Coprinus, this one is Cremini. Says, "These are what the fungal mancers and their quarters seem to require. A help against the queen. They are here to see your domain, Grand Mayor. Perhaps you will show them." Ramini takes a bow, clearly an imitation of a lot of some sort of Yuan Ti greeting. You find a certain disgust shivering through you, Mist, as you see this and are remembered. But they do this out of a politeness, not out of a subservience to them. This is what they have learned. Armini says, "May I show you the city? I am the Grand Mayor of the Myconids. We are different from the Thalids, but we still share this one home."
Mayor Cremini, is this vapor highly explosive?
We have lived with this vapor for the centuries that we have lived here. We have grown with it, and it brings us warmth. Warmth and the nutrients that we need to survive and thrive.
Nice.
It is good for us.
It's highly flammable.
Explosiveness. We have grown, some of us have grown used to the heat. Do not worry.
Is that how you're different to the Thalid?
But do beware to not light anything on fire.
I will remember that. Is your heat resistance the thing that makes you different from the Thalids?
The Thalids were created by the Grand Staff of Power. We were merely awakened by it. And that is our difference. There are different, I believe you would call them species. I apologize for my lack of knowledge of some words. It has been many centuries since we have received a guest here. The last ones, these Yuan Ti's, they taught us much, but demanded even more.
So they had to die, right?
No. They were expelled from us, our grounds. We do not kill them. If the creature wishes to, we may enlighten it, open its mind. We may share with you some. And he opens his palm and shows you some mushrooms. And he says, "You may take these and they will help you open your mind to us. They will not infest you, do not worry. That is something that the Thalids do, not us Myconids.
Alright, I'll eat it.
Okay. You eat it and start going under the very strongly and very quickly under the effect of a hallucinogenic trip. You will have to do a constitution saving throw to see if you will puke.
Let's see.
Urabi eats it, nothing happens.
Yeah. Urabi thinks this is rather
cool. Oh, I added a d6. So 12 right. Plus. Maybe oh no, I'm in. I'm 10. I have a plus 3 as well. No.
Ah yes, from mist. Okay, so that is a total of 15 then. So you resist. You resist the urge. There is a strange urge for you to puke, but you are able to keep your mind together. Oh. You find yourself actually that for some reason, Legion seems to be further away.
Ooh.
And you are more yourself.
Oh. Hello.
All right. But I'm still in the soul kind of place, right? If you
yes.
describe it like that.
But your mind is more yours.
Ooh, I try to repair the cracks.
What do you mean with this?
When I tried last time to harness more of its power, I didn't know if it was to save Mook's life or to get out of the void dimension or to get into the void. I didn't protect the core right that I left. So that the one thing that ensures that Legion can't get control over my mind, consciousness, soul, which is the thing that keeps us in contract, and there were cracks forming or it got smaller. So
yeah,
if I'm unseen in this world now and I feel like I have a chance to do that, I think I would rush to find it and
right.
repair it.
Rush in, finding your own mind, almost rushing back into your own soul, and using a power almost beyond your own, you repair your little niche, and even find a greater opening for yourself, more is now for you. Legion seems to be slightly perturbed by what is happening, and you seem to be almost invisible to it.
Ooh.
Nice.
Things going good. Everything going good.
Yeah. Should I? I mean, it's D&D. Should I roll for how good I improve it?
No. In this case, it is a flat success.
Nice.
I mean, you can try to roll. You can try to roll, but that would risk you failing.
Right, but no, but to put it in perspective, I could also roll a d100 to see of how much I managed to, you know, the harvest. I'm talking
okay.
about the harvest of the success.
Okay, right. Go ahead and roll a d100 then.
There you go. It's very little.
No, it is a success. You have opened some space for it. And you have even found, almost as if you are digging through your own mind, or perhaps through the souls of Legion that seem to stand still, almost creating this wall of dirt and corpses, you dig and find a weapon, or at least a glint of a weapon, an edge still that lies within the canopic edge.
Another edge?
A single bladed thing that as you are carving out this little space, it almost cuts you. But you are suddenly drawn back to your own mind before you are able to take full advantage of this. But somewhere within Legion, there is something, a blade, a weapon of some sort, that Legion has hid from you.
I don't know, I snap back of what has been like, what, how many seconds for the others?
Don't really know so far. You check your watch, and it seems like it has been some 15 minutes.
Oh, damn. All right, let's see what the others have done in that time.
All right. Do the others take
moving?
It?
I guess Oraba wouldn't hesitate.
Sure, why not?
Oraba would not hesitate. And Oraba seems to be just having a very good time in general. But he does comment that it's a little bit weak.
Means everyone should be prepared for constitution checks.
Well, I would take. Of course.
Okay.
I'm a fan of Plato, you take it.
Okay, you take it. And for a moment, you are able to hold it for only a little bit before you puke it out. You are not really able to resist that much, but you pass out. And in this moment, you feel as if you have transposed your mind to that of Henry's. And feel as it feels with the command that it has over not only its own little spells, but over itself, its infestation, your other little thalids. And in this strange haze that you find yourself, this strange switch of bodies, you are opened even further to the possibility of enhancing the staff, make it even greater, to evolve him into one of the little shepherds.
Oh, yes!
Damn.
See? What a great drug.
The drug of possibilities.
You don't really know exactly how to do this, or what it has done yet, but it is possible. And you find that beneath this clearly plantoid cover, there is the definite mark of undeath. But something calls on you. You find a connection. Another great necromancer is nearby.
Oh. Well.
Still fairly far. But in here.
Mm-hmm.
He seems to call on you.
Oh,
and hey. Say, visit me.
Oh, hello. I will do so much more when we see each other.
He mumbles lying.
He says, Klaatu within his puke suddenly gets a hard on. And what you do, what you hear, Klaatu, is this response saying, it has been very long since I have indulged the pleasures of the flesh.
Oh, well. We can refresh that. We can refresh that.
Greet me in the necromancy grounds. My palace.
Sounds lovely. I puke again.
Who else will take it?
Sure, why not?
Okay. You know, so I think taking care of Klaatu to like put, we're separating him from his vomit, like moving his body, pulling him by his feet.
To the side, but I don't. Okay.
Mist, you find yourself in this. You have a vision as well. You will have to make a Constitution saving throw.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Alright, 24, you seem to be fine. There is no puking. You are still fairly aware of yourself. What you are able to see is, in this case, very evidently, the presence of Melora within all of these creatures. All of them have somehow been touched by Melora's power and Melora's magic. These are part of Melora's children still, but they don't know it. There is a sadness that you feel out of each of them from not knowing their creator, the person to whom they should not only owe thanks, owe gratitude to, but truly praise and be happy for. All they have known is the oppression of Melora, and that can change. All of that can change. These creatures are perhaps the most mutable that you have found, and they are very open to the callings of this religion that you have. Paladin, order, at the same time, reacts against the presence of a Yuan-T that is here. A Yuan-T that has somehow remained here, though. Despite all of this. But then you are washed. Literally, in this case, you feel yourself being bathed almost by a tsunami of Melora's favor. Find yourself emerging from this pool, having perhaps been born anew and understanding the great equilibrium in the ecosystem that has been enormously disturbed by the Queen. And these creatures perhaps are part of them. Not plants, fungi indeed, but still part of them.
Oh boy. Okay.
Yes, oh boy.
Alright, who is the last one? Midu, do you take it as well?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay, Midu.
Not
make
20.
A constitution saving throw. Oof, with a natural 20.
Yes, I did.
A natural 20, you hear this voice calling to you. It says, creature of many forms. Creature of many species. That she who has done what we could not. Come to the transmutation pods. Help us merge flesh and fungus, as you have your scales and your leaves. We have much to learn from you, and we seek to learn from you.
Stranger danger.
Yes, I feel that too.
Does Miro know where? Is the voice telling her where it is?
The voice calls you back to the direction of the fortress.
Oh, okay.
Towards the direction of the fortress, but even further beyond. And it does seem to call on you with great interest.
Okay.
But you feel as well that there is something that is hidden from you. Something that these want to not show. And you, because of this constitution save, you are able to pry through this and find that what they do not want to show you is their infestation pits. But it is not here. It is not in the Myconid city.
It is.
And perhaps not even the Myconids know it.
Okay. But I have the general direction where it is. Like, I have an idea where it is. Alright.
You do. So, the transmutation pods are that way. The infestation pit is that way. Necromancy grounds are that way.
Okay.
It's all different directions. Okay.
Yes. Right. I will give Oraba's vision when he gets here.
Well, so he has one other thing to do, right? At Oxyphon's Garden, there was something. Does anyone remember?
Well, do you think Orob has another RP thing queued for that?
Yeah, there was a thing. Well, I will hear it when I watch the video. I guess.
All right, remember us then, because I can't remember.
Hmm.
Okay, all right. So, you wake up from these different visions, the things that call you to different places within this great and actually quite large city that resides in this underground darkness.
Did I feel a calling to a specific location? Or was mine just everywhere?
Yours was more. It was general, but at the same time, it was towards the head of these places, towards over here, the library.
Okay.
So I stand up from my puke. Oh God, I'm a mess. And prestidigitate the puke off my clothes and myself. Look at the others. Whoa, that was something. I think I have a date.
Oh. Ah, you, a date. That's what you saw?
Well, I saw barely anything, but I felt a connection to one in the necromancy grounds. Sounds interesting, right?
Yeah, but before that, thank you for the gift. Thank you very much for sharing that with us.
That was awesome. Can I have some for Lupi?
Naturally. Naturally, this is the produce that we grow and consume. And you can see that he exhales this great vapor that he has clearly been smoking something.
Awesome. I kind of like it here.
You are all welcome here. We seek everyone to be welcome here. That is what makes us happy and what drives us in this place. That is why they have chosen me as their grand mayor. I know how to enjoy this. Truly enjoy this place.
That seems a little bit too good to be true, so I incite him with 6.
I feel an almost urge to trust him.
Oh, yeah.
He has given clues. Nothing suspicious about him.
Such a nice fella.
So where will you take us next?
To see only to roam around our dear city. I have no other goals than your enlightenment.
Well, that's good.
We'll just pick a direction. Anyone want to suggest something?
Well,
he takes you. He has his whole city is an enormous place. And he shows you around, showing the different developments of the city and the different places around. The whole city is constructed almost on top of each other. There is actually some formations and within the stone, not only fungus in this place. And it seems to exist without any streets. You enter and immediately are within the house of another creature, another Mycinid, and they seem to be grateful and thankful of this. These sproutlings join at you to analyze and look at this great event that has been unfolding as you pass basically from door to door, from stairs that go up to ramps that go down and twist around to reveal this great city that has clearly grown as a living organism, but at the same time with the help, naturally, of all of these different creatures that stand here. They are all happy to see you and be able to be with you, and it is a very strange sentiment. There is a great air of jubilation, of great happiness.
In our mind, I say, I don't know how you see it, but I genuinely feel that this is a good place. From what I see right here. I think the problem is the queen, actually.
I think I'm going to have to agree with you.
Yeah.
You're suggesting we purge her?
Well, you're always so happy. Why not just purge?
Not necessarily purge her, but we need to...
I thought there was sick, right?
Yeah, we need to cure her.
Yeah, that's a better word.
And you're thinking about the mushrooms helping to heal her.
Well, they won't stand in the way.
Possibly. I mean, they seem to have an interest, and they are very open and accepting as long as we don't corrupt them.
Perhaps. Well, but they are corrupted because they don't do what they're supposed to do. They said she's the enemy now. So something happened.
Yeah, there was a memory.
Yes,
memory. Yeah,
but still, plants and mushrooms should still be doing what they're... I'm sorry, I don't believe into their total free will, since they're hive creatures. And if Melora made them, or some god made them, they were made with a purpose. And which was... to keep watch over the queen, expand under her watch, and something went wrong with her. But then something went wrong here because they stopped trying to cleanse her. They gave up on that, you know?
They did say something earlier, like they wanted to be more complete.
Yeah. So now there's some ambition mixed in there that doesn't fit the mushroom people, you know. So who do you said you had a date with, Klaatu?
I really don't know this entity, but it talked to me in my trip. And, well, he had a very nice voice. I liked the voice very much. And... it revealed itself as a necromancer.
So,
of course, another necromancer.
Yeah, isn't that great?
So that's what went wrong here.
You were in a lot of trouble. You do remember, right?
Yeah,
we had to fight somebody very, very strong.
What are you referring to, Miro?
What was his name? Lan.
Landrigan.
Yeah, that guy.
Oh, my factoid.
Well,
you were just gonna meet him, have fun, and then that, you know.
Well, yeah, I will be careful. Good, yeah, Miro. Yeah, I didn't know that you're still thinking of this. Yeah,
How have you been more careful since then?
I mean, I'm very worried, you know?
Oh, that's so nice of you, Miro.
I mean, it seems like you're the type that can't find a good guy. Yeah, that is a thing, you know?
What? I have perfect... I can read people like books.
Yeah, he just needs his penis for reading, and the books are, you know?
What? Is that so?
Well, you make it seem like it's so.
Don't have your skeletons back, and your things are still in the other world plane?
Oh, yeah.
We still haven't
If we wouldn't have helped you, you'd be this archface / Matt Smith fuck toys.
Well, yeah, perhaps.
But maybe you should be thinking a bit about this more. Like, I don't know. I mean, I don't want to stop you. Seems like you're having a lot of fun, but at the same time, I hope you're going to be okay.
I mean, that from Miro, that really puts me in another perspective. Really feel bad now. Miro, nothing against you, but you're so... Well,
maybe we just meet him all together and then see, or her all together, and then we get to know. Did anyone else see something in the visions? Mine was just a waste of time.
I just said they wanted to ask me, maybe examine me, how I became like this, like, you know, half plant, half lizard, and apparently part dragon.
Is this insight against?
For Justin's, I wouldn't have played like. It's a perfect opportunity to show that Claudio is not good with people.
I mean, I keep dropping them really good.
Nice, another not 20.
Yeah, you go. So you were told that they would need like to know something about your coming to be. Of course they would like that. Maybe that's part of their ambition, trying to merge with flesh and become more intelligent and stronger, learning more magics.
Oh, yeah. That would be my goal if I wouldn't have a body. It was my goal. I did it. High five myself. Yes.
I guess we shouldn't go there then. It felt like it was there, like over there on that direction.
Oh, then I'll point in that direction and look at Karimi and say, "Let's go there. It's a fun trip around the town, right? That looks interesting." And I start going in that direction.
Of course, you may go. I will not hold you back.
But you need to come along.
This is my city. This is what I am in charge of. You will go now into the place of the Thalids. That is not our sanctuary.
Oh, come on, but your friends. At least neighbors.
Or are you bound to this place?
I will go with you. I will go with you. Do you wish to go? Where do you wish to go, then?
Well, what lies in that direction? Let me make a perception check to see if I can find signs of something. Because I'm suggesting that Miro hasn't said going in that direction for nothing. 29.
Okay, in which direction are you pointing at, sorry?
Miro, where are you pointing at the infestation pits?
Basically, she was pointing direct. So, if I remember correctly, this was all the way to the transmutation pod, and this is the way to the infestation, which I think the voice from the transmutation pod was trying to hide, right?
Yes. Well, the infestation pit is this way down is the necromancer.
Mm-hmm.
So this way is the necromancer. This way is the library. That way, the infestation pits. And that way up is the transmutation pod.
Okay, Miro relays that to Chastin and, you know, to their site.
Then he wants to go where they don't want us to go. Let's put Karimi in a tight spot, everyone.
Okay, well, yeah.
To really test out these waters so Mist can make a decision.
Yeah, okay, let's do it. But, yeah. I want to see the necromancer at these walls.
Well, I guess that's part of him making a decision, but Mist, you tell us as soon as you say something, I'll light this place up.
Just keep looking around and see what we come up with.
Alright, in my mind, I also ask Miro to see with survival to remember the way and to see if Karimi is trying to lead us off the path to the infestation pads.
Okay, alright. So, you are going then towards the infestation pits.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Okay. He starts taking you this way.
Oh.
Seems like the correct direction for now.
Okay. The first step that you pass is... yeah. The library.
Ooh.
Hello.
You find here, again, there is another one of these enormous... and they stand before you, just as they did in the fortress, asking for permission. Kramini speaks with them telepathically, and they open. He invites you in and says, "Here we hold all that is our knowledge. We have the beings here. All that we know, we can pass on to these fungi. And when we seek to remember something, we may access them to draw from it. This is the unfortunate side effect is that sometimes we may depend on them too much, and we may grow to ignore ourselves to become one with it."
Oh.
Detect magic? Is it magic or is it organic?
It is organic.
Right.
It is organic, but this whole place has some deep transmutation magic. This whole place has been awakened by incredibly strong magics. And it, especially the library, holds this truer part of the magic. Here you find one of the fungal mancers.
Fungal mancers.
He is a large creature, larger than you are, holding his staff, and it oozes immense power. This creature has a great capacity to mold this place itself in order to serve it. He walks around with it like an old man, relying on it as this cane. Presents his name, and he says, He says, my name is Entoloma, and I am a fungal mancer.
Greetings, Entoloma.
This is the library where we keep all that is our knowledge. And deep within that which gives us our power. Why have you come here? Chosen of the gods.
In Justin's mind, he goes, well, mister, it's your time to ask the questions to get the information you need.
Well, Justin, I think I've actually already made up my mind. I'm just kind of going over the thoughts in my from the vision, and I'll turn to this who's Entoloma.
Mm-hmm.
And how does this knowledge database thing work?
We are not a hive mind, but we have a connection within us, a connection of telepathy that has been granted to us by she who has awoken us.
And who was
we
that?
We have used this to enhance the minds of some of us so that they may keep the wisdom of all of our years. We give to this database, as you call it. And we give to this database, as you call it, what we wish to give to it. Our creativity, our knowledge, our power. But there are those who always choose to not give to it. Either because they are unsure of the truth of what they, of their thoughts, or perhaps because they fear some of their competitors, or perhaps because they simply do not wish to connect to it at all.
Are there any side effects for connecting to it?
The only side effect is if your mind is not disciplined, you may waste yourself in the lives of others and not have your own.
Mm-hmm. Oh, well.
Can non-fungus or non-myconids connect to it?
Only whilst under the effect of an enhancer.
Orobar steps forward. Can I try that?
What is this enhancer? Is that the same thing that the mayor gave us back in the city?
No. You need something different. It is not a mind opener that you need, but something else.
Like what? A different drug or a device?
I may give it to you. but it may be aggressive towards non-fungal bodies.
Must be like a catalyst.
It can consume you and your mind. Turn you into one of us, despite you not wanting it.
Oh. Justin holds Oroba back. Step back, mate. You don't want to become a mushroom, do you? You said you'd eat them.
But if I were to share what's in my mind, all of the myconids and salads would share it as well?
All of them would know it, yes. All who wish to access it.
You're thinking of leaving a message?
In a way, yeah. Let me think on that a little bit. Let's go.
Well, I imagine you'd be a very squishy mushroom, you water genasi.
Possibly. Let me consider the options. And let's continue on with traveling wherever we were going to begin with.
When you were a mushroom and times were really harsh, would you let us cut pieces off to eat? I mean, it's going to regrow, right?
I can create food with a spell. You wouldn't need to eat me.
Well, but what if you can't cast magic where we are?
Okay, all right. Okay, guys, I think this is a good place to stop. This gives you enough ideas of where you would want to go. I am going to reveal to you the entire map of this place.
Oh, damn, you're the real master of 50 Shades of Grey.
What?
Well, I have here tattoo for the sex part of it, I guess.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
All right, so this is the Myconid and the Fungal City. So this is the entrance. This whole place is supposed to be huge. Like, these are actually like kilometers. And there are thousands of different myconids and such that live in here. And this is the different place that you will explore. Right now you are at the library. Let me put a token to symbolize that you are at the library. And that is it. Okay, so we'll see each other next week, right? And we'll continue. I prepared all of these with like really hard magics and stuff. In case you would seek to destroy them.
Nice.
But now I guess they will serve as perhaps Klaatu's evolutions.
Who knows? So next week, how about Thursday or Wednesday? I can't do Monday.
I'd say I prefer Wednesday the 17th.
Would be perfect for me.
I have something on the 17th, but I'm not sure if it is this late. So perhaps I'll warn you when I'll be sure of it, okay, guys?
Mm-hmm.
Because it takes 1 hour. And yeah, so but I'm pretty sure that it is at 4. I'm just not certain.
If we don't hear anything from you, we will assume it's going to be Wednesday.
Okay. Yeah, I think that would be best.
Okay. Is that all right with you, Ryza?
Wednesday's good, yeah.
Okay. Then Jeff?
Works for me.
Okay, so write it in chat for Niklas and good night. Thank you for the great sesh.
Yeah.
Alright, see you guys and I hope you enjoyed another definitely more grayish culture.
Every time that happens, we do.
All right. Still, you could have still burnt this whole place to the ground, and I was.
We might still do it.
You might still do it.
Let's see the infestation pets and talk to the necromancer first.
And there's also a two more, whatever this is about. Okay. I wish you guys the best. Have a good night or a good day.
Yeah.
See you next week, everyone.
Mm-hmm. Ryza, you are... Oh, damn it, she's gone. I was about to say that she needs to tell us when the baby's there. I think it was close last time already, right?
Was it?
She was like weeks or just 1 month. I can't remember. Chris will know once he watches the videos. All right, everyone. See you around.
See you.